What's up, YouTube? So today I want to show you guys how to downgrade your iOS device from 9.3 to 9.2.1. I'm on the latest 9.21 build, which is 13E20 or 237, which was released today, March 28th, 2016. So if you guys want to downgrade in the future here, if Apple isn't signing the firmware, you won't be able to downgrade. If they are signing 9.21 when you watch this video, you will be able to downgrade. So just to kind of clear up some confusion in my previous videos, you really have to, like, the website that I suggest, I would strongly suggest using this website, since you can actually see which firmwares are being signed, so you know which firmwares you can downgrade to. I'll make sure I put the link in the description. You can head to your device here, and then you can see here that the earlier 9.3 build isn't being signed, but the latest 9.3 build is being signed, as well as the 9.2.1 build is being signed. So you're going to want to download the firmware that's being signed, or this method isn't going to work for you. So as long as you are covered there, you'll be able to downgrade no problem. The process is the same as before, so it's pretty easy to do. You want to plug your device into iTunes, make sure you're running, you know, the latest version. Once you've completed and downloaded that folder, the firmware file, you're just going to want to hold the Option key and hit the restore. So if I hold the Option key, which is just right here, down on the Option key on a Mac, you'll actually get this pop-up window where you can navigate to where you've saved your folder or your downloads. So mine should be just right in here. And as you can see, I have the 9.3 and then 9.21. So I want to restore to this 9.21. If you're on Windows and you want to do this, the process is the exact same, guys. All you have to do is just hold the Shift key. So instead of the Option key on a Mac, it is the Shift key for Windows, and you'll get this pop-up. If you don't, you'll just hit it and it'll say you're on, it'll do this, and this is not what you want to do. Now, I've had a few people ask, and yes, this does wipe your device completely, so make sure you have a backup of your device before you begin. And we'll just begin here. So I'm on iOS 9.3, and we're going to downgrade to 9.2.1, and hit OK, and then the process will begin. So I'm just gonna let it run, and you guys can chill out and watch the downgrade. So you guys can see the serial number there. The device, I'm not gonna change it out. It'll be the same device once we get downgraded to 9.2.1. At this point, if you receive an error, that means Apple isn't signing the firmware. So the signing process basically happened right when you seen the iTunes screen there. Once the device reboots and you get the bar underneath the Apple logo here, it just basically runs like a normal restore. So I'll speed up the video for you guys, because this process can take about 5 to 10 minutes depending on your computer and which device you're restoring. Again, I'm restoring here an iPhone 4S, but this will work all the way up to the iPhone 6S. Also works on iPads, all the way up to the latest iPads, even the iPad Pro and the iPod Touch 6th edition, and even the 5th edition if you're still using that. So All right, the restore is complete. Now we're just going to wait for the device to boot up and go through the activation menu. And here we are on iOS 9.2.1. I'm just going to go through the activation quick. All right, here we go, guys. And another successful downgrade here. So as long as Apple is signing the firmware, you should have no issues downgrading any of your devices to the firmware previous, just like shown here. I'm back on iOS 9.2.1. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and we'll see you again next time.